It's me, Stomp The Bean, and welcome back to yet another episode of Crainer Craft 1 and 2. I don't know which one it is. But anyway, guys, if you're still enjoying this series, then please do hit that like button down below. Also, if you're new to my channel, then please do subscribe for daily Minecraft videos. Anyway, let's get on with it. I've been doing a lot of work. What can I show you first? Oh my gosh, it's all so exciting. Right, first of all, I built a mob spawner. I used the cursed earth. Let me show you. Look, it's in there. All that cursed earth is in there. All I did was put like a couple of pieces down, and then it spread throughout the rest of the dirt that I put down. And then we've got a conveyor belt inside here, if I can just sort of somehow show you. Let's break that. There we go. There's a conveyor belt. Hopefully they're not going to come out, because if they do, I'm going to have to get Big Bertha out. There we go. So we've got like a whole area here with cursed earth that I used by getting a silk touch pickaxe. Yes, silk touch. I got it wrong last episode. I said something else. Why has that turned off? What's going on with the power situation? This is not good. Everything has powered down. Hello? Did something happen? Oh no! I don't want power problems. I want it all to work, please. Please just work for me. Please. I need to get out of here. This way. There we go. Right. Let's go and have a look. Is there a power issue? Why has my power been drained? Is that draining power, perhaps? I don't know. I've no idea what has gone on with my power. Oh, no. Yeah, I may have washed some torches away there. Okay, I'm going to disappear and fix this little problem. And I'll be back and show you all the updates and things that I've done. I'll see you soon. Bye. Okay, so I figured the problem, and I was going to do it off cam, but I thought I'd share it with you guys. We're out of lava. We've had some issue with the lava. It looks like I've collected as much lava as I possibly can from the Nether, so it means I need to go move my machine wherever that may be. It's got to be down here somewhere. I'm thinking it's down here. Look at all this cobble and stone that I've created here. Okay, so this was where the machine was, and that's where it is now. So, whoa. We really have done a number on the old lava lake here, haven't we? Right, so if we just pick all this up, and we're going to place all this down somewhere over here. Look at this stuff. I can't believe it. Wow. We really have taken the lava away. So if we just put it... wow. Awesome. There's a ghast with a giant pig on his head. Big Bertha away! Big Bertha away! Away! There we go. What is that all about? Hello spiders. Bye spiders. Right, okay, so let's put the endothermic pump down. There we go. I didn't really want to do this now, but never mind. Then the lava generator just there. Then the tank on top. There we go. There we go. That's filling up with lava. And then the transfer node to put lava into there. There we go. So hopefully that'll continue making lava for us. Fingers crossed. And I can head out of here and head back home. The portal is this way, according to the what's it? There it is. I can see it. Cool. Right. I did bring a bucket of lava just in case I need to restart it, but never mind. So hopefully that's got all our power back. And we can get on with what I was planning on doing. I need to still show you exactly what it is that I've done to the base. I've done a few little updates, a few little things that I think needed doing. It had to be done. And as you may have saw, we've got a lot of mob essence coming out of... Yeah, there we go. We've got power again. Finally. Thank you. yeah. So, like I was saying, I built a mob spawner. And what I've got is that conveyor, and then I've got all these fans running via these blocks of redstones, because that was just the easiest way I could think to power them. And they're pushing through the wall and pushing all the mobs into the center where the conveyor belt is. And I've got them this side too. There you go. So you can see them there. I do need to fill this hole in my base, because anybody could get in without going through the door. But the fans seem to push me. Like, I'm letting go and I'm moving back. Like, they push me even though I'm not doing anything. So this is what happens with all the mob essence and stuff. It just goes into the ender chest and then goes straight into the ME system. And obviously we're using a grinder here, which is full of essence. So we're going to start using that essence soon and taking it away. What I need to do is just get myself some cobble and close up all the holes. Colored cobblestone, black frequency, that's the one. And let's just close up these holes now, because I'm not wanting to see them anymore. Can I get one behind there? I cannot. Okay, never mind. It just looks odd, that's all. There we go. And let's go and close up this one. So, as you may have saw a moment ago, downstairs we have mob essence by the thousands of millibuckets. I was going to fill this entire area with stuff and completely fill up the area with mob essence. I thought that might be a good idea, but I've got enough there for now. What I am going to do, and what I have also done off camera, is I've made myself a tesseract, as you can see there. Fairly easy. I needed to get myself a magma crucible and a fluid transposer again, so that I can transpose resonant ender inside the tesseract. I made the tesseract frame by doing this, making enderium and all that sort of thing. And to make enderium, you need enderium base. And pyrophium dust and some enderpearls and an alloy smelter, which I did myself to get enderium base. You need silver ingot, shiny ingot, and tin ingot, which again I did. And then all I did was EMC'd it, which made it really, really easy. So if I type in test, there we go. You can see I've got tesseract frames, empty tesseract frames. I could take 64 of those out and just fill these up in the fluid transposer. If I put those up there like that, and then just go and grab myself some ender pearls out of here. E-N-D-E-R, there we go. If we grab some ender pearls, we'll just grab 3 stacks for now, and put those into the magma crucible. You will see that the magma crucible will take that fluid and then it will transfer it straight into this one. So look, there we go. We got ourselves 2 tesseracts now. Fairly easy stuff. And we need to make quite a few tesseracts, because they're going to come in handy. So what we're going to do is we're going to try and take the mob essence out of here. Now I'm wondering if I put a tesseract down like so. I didn't want to do that one. That was an accident, thank you. If I put a tesseract down, it just says it's a tesseract frame. Why is it not turned into a tesseract? Is there something I'm doing wrong? Tesseract frame full. Well, how does one get a tesseract? A tesseract's like banned in this thing? Can transfer items, fluids, and RF. So, let's put one there. But I can't access it. Well, this is annoying. Okay, so I'm going to go away and just Google something and see what the problem is. Okay, so looking online, it tells me that I need bronze ingot. Bronze, there we go. And I think it was like so. Can we put the bronze in my inventory? Let's just get rid of some of this stuff. Lead can go, Enderium base can go, copper can go, pyrothium can go. Let's just try and get rid of all of this, because I kind of need to have some space here. Coloured cobblestone, you can go as well. What I need to do is put the tesseract in there. Then I need silver. Silver ingots. There we go. And I think they go like this. And hopefully, if all is done correctly, maybe I've just got those the wrong way round, it should turn into a tesseract. There we go. Finally. Why it does that, I do not know. I've no idea. But that's how we make a tesseract. And I should have another couple of full ones in there. So I should be able to make 10 tesseracts here. If I've got enough. Let's have a look. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Is it 5 I've got? Yeah. No, 6. That's enough. That's enough for me. That's fine. Right, so what I want to do is I want to connect my tesseract to this system here. And I'm wondering whether it'll pull directly or do I need a liquid transfer node. I think what I'll do is get a liquid transfer node. So if I put L-I-Q, there we go, liquid transfer node. Thank you very much. We'll place that just here. There we go. And then we shall place our tesseract right next to it. So that is now going to be set. We'll call this channel 1 liquid. Channel 1 liquid. Yes. We shall make that a channel. We'll add that channel. Then we'll configure it to send fluid only. We'll block that, and we'll block that. Right, there we go. That is now... am I seriously looking right now at the face of the famous actor, Nicolas Cage? Seriously? I mean, that is Nicolas Cage, right? Nicolas Cage is inside my tesseract. What the crap? Right. Okay, so now we've done that. We know that our tesseract will send us liquid, which is cool, and it will send us an unlimited amount, which is awesome. Right, now we need to hook it up to some power. So, if we put a tesseract just here, will it let me place a tesseract? There we go. Is that, yeah, that's connected to power. And we're going to call this one power. Oh, no, we're going to set this up to liquid, but we're going to send it to blocked on fluid. Items we are going to block, and then we are going to put energy mode send. So it will now send energy. Let me just check. No, we didn't set that up properly, did we? no, we're going to put it to liquid. There we go. And liquid one, set up to energy mode, send. There we go. Right, cool. It's Nicolas Cage again. Oh my gosh. Right, so now we've done that, what we want to do is make ourselves... We'll get rid of those. A mob... Is it a mob spawner? Let's put mob... and see what we get. Mob, there should be a machine. Mob counter, mob router. Maybe if I put spawner, we might get something else. S-P-A-W-N. Let's have a look. There's 6 different items, 6 different pages. Is this it? Auto spawner, there we go. So, we want to make one of those. Hopefully we got all the materials. We're close. We are very close. Auto spawner, where are you? You've just disappeared on me. Please. Alright, let's type it in because it's so much easier. A-U-T-O. Auto spawner. Auto brewer. Autonomous activator. Auto spawner. There we go. So, we need nether wart and 2 magma cream. Is that right? Let me just check. Nether wart and 2 magma cream. Okay, so it's back to the nether. I'm going to go and get those off camera, and as soon as I do... wait. We've always got to check here. Mag. Oh, look. What am I doing? Talking about going to the nether? What's that all about? Let's have a look for nether wart. N-E-T. Come on, nether wart. I know you're in here somewhere. You've got to be. Look at that! You beauty! I was just about to cut the video and go and do that. What am I like? Right, okay, so we've got nether wart just there. Chuck that in the system, because quite clearly we've got none in the system. Magma cream gets us an auto spawner. Yes, thank you very much. Very happy about that. Then I want a safari net. Safari net. And I want the reusable one, which is easy. There we go. We'll take one of those. Right. Now I'm going to need a ton of cobblestone. There we go. I've got to get rid of some of this stuff in my inventory. Let's just get rid of that. We get rid of the arrows. Get rid of that. Get rid of the lava. I need the tesseract. I need the builder's wand. Glass can go. I need the cobble. You can go. You can go. And you can go. Right. Okay. So I need a bit more cobblestone. There we go. And I want conveyor belts, which I should have in here already. There we go. We got 54 conveyor belts. I'm thinking I might want more than that. So let's just make some more. I'm pretty sure I can do that. Conveyor. There we go. Yeah, I'm sure I can do this. Come on. 54 and 64. There we go. That's plenty. Plenty there. Right. And some sort of... Now what do I want? Energy? Or... no, because I've got the tesseract. I've got the tesseract. I don't know what I'm talking about. Right. I'm going to go up into the nether. I'm going to get set up. And, yeah. Okay. So, we're ready. We're all set. Right. We've got our tesseract here pumping liquid. Just to recap. We've got our tesseract over here pumping energy with... Nicolas Cage. I don't know what that's all about. And then we have our tesseract in the nether, which, oh, we're not going out there. First things first, I've got a skeleton spawn egg. I've made a reusable safari net. What we're going to do is we're going to grab a skeleton. We're going to put him there, and then we're going to capture him in the reusable safari net. Right, then we're going to go out in the rain and possibly die, but we're going to head to the nether. And hopefully, get out of the rain, get out of the rain. Hopefully we'll survive. We did, indeed, there we go. And then you'll see in the nether, we are all set up for our skeleton, look at all these red ants. We're all set up for our skeleton murdering machine. Right, so, first things first, let's put down I didn't mean to do that. That was an accident. Can we fix it? Oh man, why'd I do that? I've always got a derp. Always. Right, we got our skeleton killing machine all set up. We just need to put that down there. There we go, right. So as you can see, any skeletons that fall out of this spawner will turn into that stuff. I don't know what they're gonna do. Right, so if we click on this, and then we click on the actual tesseract, we're gonna set it to liquid one. We're going to set it to energy mode, receive only, and then we're going to block that and block that, so that it only just, all it's going to do is put out energy. Is it going to be Nicolas Cage again? It's Nicolas Cage again, look. What's going on? Right, so once we've done that, we're going to put our grinder down. Nicolas Cage. We're going to put our grinder down, which was then it's going to get power. Yes, awesome. Oh, idea. Let's break this. Thank you. We're going to set that to item fluid send only. Because any fluid that comes out of killing these will reuse and send back. So there we go. Right, where is that ghast? Because I'm not having him destroy my hard work that I've done here. I'm just not having it. Right, okay, so that's that done. So, if you blow up my stuff, I promise you it'll be the last thing you do. Where are you? There you are, right. Meet my friend, Big Bertha. You could throw what you like at me, mate. It's your game is over. Come here. There you go. Give me that ghast here. Thank you. Right. Anyway, as I was saying, so now we've set up this system, all we need to do is set it up like what we've got at home on our normal mob spawner, which is to put that there and then put this ender chest here. So any items that are collected from this system will automatically go into the ender chest and then end up at our lovely, lovely ME system. Right, so now we've done that. That is all set up. We've just got to set up the power so that it's getting... Yeah, look, it's getting power. And then we go, look, that is one of them skeletons thingies because he's in the nether. And there's another one with the skeletons. They're just going to carry on and carry on and carry on. They're just going to spawn like crazy in here. And I'm going to end up with unlimited wither skeleton bones. Necrotic bones. That's the word I was looking for. And it's going to automatically be sent to my house. And I'm quite happy. So I'm going to leave that running. There is a little spider up there. You see him? You see him? Let's take care of you. Bye. I'm going to leave that running. I'm just going to head home and I want to make sure that the necrotic bones are going into my system. So if I type in wither, I should have, I believe. Yeah, alright, dude. Alrighty then, it's raining. I should have in my system. Let's just eat some food because I'm like proper dying. I should have in my system, I think it is 3 wither skeleton skulls. So if I type in necrotic bones. Look, I've got 4 already. Necrotic bones, 4 already. If I type in wither, I've got 3 skulls. Alright, so I've still got 3, but I've got 4 necrotic bones, which means that I can continue with making these heart canisters. So all this hard work has all come up to... look. Nicolas Cage. All this hard work has come up to me getting these heart canisters, but it's totally been worth it, and I'm actually really quite pleased. What I want to do next is try and figure out, because my condenser is just like full, because I'm reusing the EMC to make these things, and the only way to empty that condenser is to put it into here, but I have to do it manually. So Junaid Mahmood, if you know a way to automatically do it, let me know. I've already dug a tunnel so that I can send a pipe to it, but what pipe work can I use? Let me know. That would be awesome. We've got 2 spare tesseracts. We could use those for something, I'm sure. But anyway, guys, unfortunately, we have just about run out of time on this episode of Crainer Craft 1 and 2. If you did enjoy this episode, then please do hit that like button down below. Also, if you are new to my channel, then please do subscribe for daily Minecraft videos. Yes, subscribe. But anyway, guys, thanks very much for watching. I've been Stomp The Bean. This has been Crainer Craft. Goodbye.